my life. I said, Lord, I don't know whether I'm saved or not. I want you to show me. Mm-hmm. But your word says that if I call on you, you'll save me.
Amen.
And I want to nail that down right now. Your word, you'll save me. I'm ashamed to admit this, but I was a young preacher, Mike. I was preaching revival. And I was sitting there on the pew and I said, I can't preach. I haven't even been saved. And I said, Lord, I've got to get this nailed down. Your word says it. I stand on it.
Yes.
Because it's true.
Yes.
And a peace like a river filled my heart.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes,
bless him,
Lord.
Yes. I'm going to heaven, church.
Amen. Amen.
Not because of anything I've done,
no.
But because what Christ did for me on Calvary. And I want to tell you something. He cannot lie.
That's right.
That's right.
And he said, I'll save you if you'll call on me. I don't know if somebody's here lost and you need to be saved. Somebody here might be like I was. You just need to get it nailed down. You just need to get it nailed down. The word said it. I believe it.
Yes.
And I'm going to stand up. While we stand and say, this time you need to pay what
you just have. As I am without one plea.
He'll give you that peace. I'm discouraged in me. I get discouraged in life, but I'm not discouraged because of where I'm headed this morning.
Yes.
Anything on your heart before we dismiss?
We have a couple of couples here celebrating anniversaries this week. We're not talking about first anniversaries either. I think it's Ruby and Carolyn.
Yeah.
Donnie and Rebecca.
Yeah, Reuben and Carolyn said it. They celebrated their 13th anniversary. Oh, 91st, I heard. Don and Rebecca celebrated theirs. Grateful for that.
You celebrated our 8th.
All right. So we got Jeff and Victoria also celebrated their anniversary.
You know, this week I seen a video, and I'm a big Ben Shapiro fan. Ben's Jew, though. And seen a clip of, he had a preacher on one of the shows one day. And the preacher asked him, said, who do you think Jesus is? Well, he was, He was just a man and said he tried to overthrow the Roman government, and for his trouble he was crucified for it. And I thought, well, that ain't exactly right. And they talked on there for a few minutes, and Ben just got him off of it. He said, I'm not interested in that. You know, and I hope and pray that someday Ben sees Jesus for who he really is.
Amen.
And gets saved.
Amen.
And what a smart young man.
Yes.
Good morals, just a shining beacon in the journalistic world, I think, you know. But he needs to be saved.
Amen.
He really does. But heaven help people say, I'm just not interested. We've all heard it before.
Yeah. Yes. Amen. Amen. Friend of mine, Richard Al Smith, some of you might know him.
Mm-hmm.
He used to witness, to testify people. He was one of the biggest door knockers you ever seen. He'd go out and knock on doors. And one man told him one time, I'm not interested. Al said, it's okay, one day you will be. And he just turned and walked off. You know, we can't make them accept.
Right.
The Holy Spirit is the one that has to do that.
Yes, it does.
Anything else?
Yeah. A couple of weeks ago, a friend of mine had a birthday. I'm so proud of her. It was Martha. But we didn't get to give her accolades because somebody else had a birthday. It kind of took precedence. So, happy birthday, Martha.
All right, anything else before we say prayer?
You know, Jerry, sitting over here at this bench right there trying to concentrate on playing the right notes. It just overwhelmed me with the spirit of the people sitting out here in the congregation this morning. It really, really, really touched my heart.
Amen.
Forgive me for all the mistakes I made, but nonetheless, it was an observation I had, and I was just watching, and it just brought joy to my heart.
Amen. Bless you, Steve. Thank you so much. I do appreciate our little church. I really do.
Amen.
Love each one of you. Thank God for you. 6 o'clock tonight, we'll be meeting again and invite you to come back and be with us in this service. And hopefully, we'll get our pastor back next week. So you won't have to listen to me much more.
Oh.
I appreciate y'all so much.
Before we go.
Okay.
Sorry.
No.
And I did enjoy the message this morning. Yes. The church gave these out a couple weeks ago for Christmas to each family. And there's some of you here today that weren't here and you need to get yours. I've got them up here. But everybody wanted me to explain what they were. So there's a piece of yarn in here that you attach it and hang it on your wall. And there's some little discs in the back. There's round discs and there's heart-shaped discs. And you take those discs and so say like, my birthday's in October. So you would hang a disc under October with my name and date on it that's my birthday. And it's for your family, for anniversaries, birthdays. It's just something to help you remember. Then you hang it on the wall, and then you walk by and you see, oh, I didn't forget her birthday. I'm going to wish her a happy birthday or something. You know, it was just something neat that I thought, or the church thought you might like. So anyway, if you just take the little silver disc and hang them underneath that you can just attach, and you'll have some months that have one, some that have two or three. It's a really cool thing. So anyway, just explain.
All right, thank you for that explanation. Well, no, don't forget about today.
It's kind of hard to.
God bless you. You're dismissed at this time.